Hey everyone, my name is Becca. I'm part of the team here at Tomorrow Bio. And in this video, I'm going to be debunking the 10 most common myths and misconceptions about cryonics. If you have any questions during this video, make sure to leave them in the comments below. And while you're at it, be sure to subscribe to get more content just like this. Myth number one, cryonics is impossible. While it's true that it isn't currently possible to revive someone out of cryopreservation, there's no fundamental biological reason why it will never be possible. There are a lot of innovations from space travel to heart transplants that were thought impossible for the majority of human history. And yet, now a lot of those impossibilities have become standard. That's not to say that it will definitely guarantee be possible that cryopreserved patients can be revived. It is still speculative, that's important to note. But saying that it's impossible, that's incorrect. Myth number two, cryonics is only for the rich. This is one of the most common assumptions about cryonics. It's why it's often so quickly dismissed, because people assume that it's only an option for millionaires and billionaires. But this is not actually the case. The cost of whole body cryopreservation is 200,000 euros, and the cost for brain-only cryopreservation is 60,000 euros. And it's true, most people don't just have those funds laying around. But you also don't need to, because the funds don't need to be paid up front. Most people fund their cryopreservation through a life insurance policy. Let's say that you're around 20 years old and you're relatively healthy. If you get a term life insurance policy that covers full body cryopreservation, it'll cost you around 20 euros per month. You don't exactly need to be a millionaire to afford that. Myth number three, cryonics is bad for the environment. There are usually two main reasons why this assumption is made. The first is this idea that patient maintenance is done with a bunch of electricity. You have to keep the patients cooled. But this is actually not the case. Cryopreserved patients are placed in dewars filled with liquid nitrogen, which is naturally at negative 196 degrees Celsius. There is no electricity used to keep patients cryopreserved. The other reason why a lot of people assume that cryonics is bad for the environment is the idea that cryonics could contribute to overpopulation in the future. But there are a few reasons why this doesn't quite add up. First of all, today there are only around 500 people in cryopreservation, and several thousand people worldwide signed up to be cryopreserved. That number could have no meaningful impact on the population. Another thing to consider is that fertility rates are steadily dropping worldwide, and it's projected that humanity will reach its peak population between 2060 and 2100. And after that, if anything, the problem is going to be depopulation, not overpopulation. Myth number four, cryonics is pseudoscience. It's easy to assume that cryonics is just some theoretical idea based on some sci-fi stories. But in reality, there is real science to back the idea that cryonics could work. For example, research has shown that you can cryopreserve model organisms called C. elegans and then revive them with their memories intact. While humans are obviously a lot more complicated than C. elegans, this kind of research shows that there is actual science behind the idea of cryonics. It's not just theoretical. Myth number five, cryonics is basically just freezing. There seems to be this idea that we just take patients and put them directly into a freezer and say goodbye until the future. But freezing is really bad for the cells. Think about the last time you put a vegetable in the freezer, and when it came out, it was not the same. In reality, cryopreservation is a much more complicated and careful medical procedure, which includes perfusing the body with cryoprotective agents and a process called vitrification, which involves transforming the body into a glass-like amorphous state. Essentially, we are preserving a person with little to no freezing. Myth number six. Cryonics is trying to achieve immortality. The point of cryonics isn't to make people live forever. We simply want to give people the opportunity to choose how long they want to live. If someone doesn't think 80 to 90 years is enough for them, they should have the chance to live longer than that. Myth number 7, cryonics is a scam. People sometimes assume this because cryonics is speculative. When people sign up for cryopreservation, they don't know whether future revival will be possible. It's the responsibility of cryonics providers to make it clear that cryopreservation can only provide a chance for future life extension, not a guarantee. As long as people are making the decision to sign up with informed consent, no scam is taking place. With such a long-term project like cryonics, trust is really important. That's why we here at Tomorrow Bio strive to be as transparent and accessible as possible. If you have any questions at all, you can schedule a call with us on our website or using the link in the description. You can also contact us to schedule a visit to our office in Berlin so that you can meet the Tomorrow Bio team and see our standby ambulance in person. Myth number 8, cryonics will revive people in an old and aching body. The point of cryonics isn't just to wake people up in the future. It's to give them a healthy, extended life. Obviously, there would be no point in reviving someone just for them to keel over and die of old age 3 days later. The good news is that there are already researchers today working on longevity and anti-aging technology. While it's not likely that those technologies will be around anytime soon, it's almost certainly the case that anti-aging is an easier problem to solve than reviving someone out of cryopreservation. So, in all likelihood, by the time revival might be possible, anti-aging would be standard practice. And if, for whatever reason, anti-aging is not far enough along by the time revival becomes possible, we could simply wait. Because again, there's no time limit to how long someone can be cryopreserved without degradation. So, patients can wait for the right technologies. Myth number 9, cryonics disrupts the natural life and death order. We already have plenty of medical interventions today, from vaccines to organ transplants that extend our lives. And the only reason that we don't consider these unnatural is because they're standard practice. But in reality, modern medicine and cryonics have the same fundamental goal, which is to give people the maximum healthy lifespan that's possible. Myth number 10, cryonics is selfish. Imagine you had a loved one who was dying of some rare kind of cancer and there was no good treatment available, but there's an experimental treatment that might be able to help them. And they want to take it. They want to spend their own money to take their chance at life. Would you really consider them selfish for trying? In essence, cryonics is an experimental life-extending technology. People that sign up for cryopreservation are choosing to spend their own money to take a chance in the future when modern medicine can no longer help them. There's nothing inherently selfish about that. There are a lot of myths and misconceptions about cryonics. Those were just a few of the ones that we've seen most often. If you think we've missed any or didn't dive deep enough into any of these, be sure to let us know in the comments below. Thank you for tuning in. We hope to see you in the next video.